This is a code walkthrough for the example file StringParsing.java. So let's open that up and take a look at it. What's nice about this example is two things. It's nice and short. We can see the whole thing on one screen. And parsing is a nice application of many of the methods of the string class that we've gone over. So as always, let's start by compiling this and running it to make sure everything works fine. And now let's take a look at what we've got here. What we're doing is we're trying to extract this word in this larger string and clean it up, capitalize it, and print it out. So the way we're going to do that is we'll start by finding the location of these two delimiters, these two commas. So we'll find the first comma. Notice that we've defined the comma as being the sep character. So we'll find the first one at loc1, which will be this location right here. Then once we know where the location of this comma is, we'll use that as a jumping off point to find this second comma. And to do that, we'll use the overloaded form of index of, which takes two arguments. So let's go ahead and put a breakpoint on this and start running it. So we'll define our string and our separator character. And we'll find the first comma at loc1, and then we'll use that to find the next comma. But rather than starting our search from 0 by default, we're going to start searching at loc1 plus 1, which means we're going to start searching for the second comma one space past this first comma. And that's going to tell us that this other comma is at index 13. So now that we know the location of the two commas which bound this substring we're after, we can extract that substring. So remember that we don't want to include the comma in that, so we're going to go one index space past that. And the second argument, as you remember, will be one space before loc2, so we're going to extract this string right here into tiger string. And what we're going to do here is we're going to apply the trim method. So we're going to take off any leading or trailing white space, clean up the string, so to speak. So notice that this will change a little bit. And finally, we're going to apply the uppercase method to turn that into the uppercase string equivalent, and we're going to write it back over itself. So now we've got the desired string in uppercase, and we're simply going to print out the extracted string and its length. So here's the string we're after, and it's correctly of length 6. The nice thing about extracting the string in this way, rather than hard coding any indices in these statements, is that this program is fully general. What we mean by that is we can mess up this string in any way we want to and put in some random number of spaces. We're going to terminate this execution. We're going to recompile it because we've changed this code. But now if we run this program again, we're still going to extract the same string of length 6, no matter what we've done to the string. So we prefer to work with strings in this way, using general terms rather than hard coding numerical values for any of these index of or substring method calls.